Vai, puoi fare la pizza. Sì. Devi fare così. Così, adesso. Vai.
È un schiaffo.
Sì, bravo.
These few days are an incredible adventure. I've been to Naples, I think in 2007 for my first Giro d'Italia, but it was only a night over. And to be able to walk the streets, feel all this energy from the city, see the goods and the not so good and all the contrast that the city gives was really interesting. There's a lot of surprises. Naples is chaotic, interesting, and the third word, I would say spectacular. Everything from washing hanging out windows to the flags, it's extremely colorful. We had some interesting talks with some of the locals.
Maradona, uno dei migliori del mondo, lo sai meglio di me.
Maradona is like everywhere.
E secondo voi qual è il gol più bello?
Ah,
con la mano?
No.
He was, I think, 82 or 83, if I remember well, and he just remembered, I think, almost every single goal from Maradona.
Scatta una, seconda, terza, panza in basso. Lui è il pallone. A scatta anche il portiere. Ti ricordi?
Even the people, it's incredible when, you know, just walking down the street, everything was very different to what I was used to. Obviously the coffee is quite strong, it's renowned to be strong. Due espressi, per favore. Two espresso. I was told that, you know, there is this kind of reputation of Napolitan being very fiery and quite almost aggressive. And one of the reasons why in Napoli everyone is full gas is because they drink too much coffee. Because they drink 4 or 5 coffees a day, and it's supposedly one of the strongest coffee that there is in Italy.
Prima l'acqua.
Prima l'acqua.
Per pulire il palato, per degustare un buon caffè.
Okay.
So the coffee, that they always say it's 1.5 zips. So I had 1.5, but I always doubted if it was the water or the coffee first, so now I know, water first. We rode the last kilometers of the Giro d'Italia stage, and I was absolutely amazed by the scenery. I always imagined that around Naples was quite flat, and I was very surprised of how difficult that circuit was. From the promenade, up this kind of really steep climb, back down the other side, again along the seafront, all these little bergs. 3 to 4 kilometer climbs, spectacular views, stunning. With the crew, had the pleasure to try and taste so many different flavors.
So apparently we arrived at the place where we can eat the best pizza in the world. As you can see, the queue has already started. If you go to Napoli, you have to go to this place. The queues can be up to 2 hours for a slice of pizza. It's quite crazy. Let's see if it's worth it.
I was so lucky we got to meet Gino, which is one of the grandsons of their Sodello family. And it was incredible. He threw me into the kitchen. I even did my own pizza.
Devi fare così. Così. Vai. Vai, vai, vai. Così. Adesso. Vai.
È un schiaffo.
Sì, bravo. Vai. Adesso puoi girare senza superare il bordo, con la pancia del cucchiaio. Bravo.
Okay.
Ok. Facciamo così, bello abbondante. Così, una bella cascata di mozzarella. Ah, okay. 1, 2, 3. Ok. Foto. Andiamo in forno.
Where do you eat a Napolitana pizza? Elsewhere than in Napoli.
Ecco la tua pizza.
Cin cin.
Alla salute.
Alla salute.
One thing I realized the last few days was the amount of carbs we ate.
Due sfogliatella calda, per favore.
So many types of buns, sfogliatella, which I had to try.
E così. Grazie mille.
From breakfast to lunch to dinner to merenda, all I think we ate was purely carbs.
10.
Non vi preoccupate.
The last couple of years, the importance of carb into the diets has just grown and grown and grown. So let's say I'm on track now for going for a bike spin.
Oh, I need to go as long as I can on the bike. Andiamo!
One of the main streets in Naples is quite renowned for statues, miniature statues. And I have to admit, it took us some time before we found a cyclist. We found one and only.
We found a Pantani riding a Bianchi.
And of course, being in Italy, it had to be Marco Pantani. We were lucky he was riding actually a Bianchi, which was quite funny for the video.
The water is just really, really blue. It's almost like if you had a pencil. In Ireland, when they ask me what color the sea is, you paint it gray.
So now we are just in front or behind the Faraglioni, and it's like a postcard. I only have one word for Capri. Wow. It's breathtaking. Capri is absolutely breathtaking. We could see it from Naples the other days, and it just looks like this little island in the far. The views are absolutely from a different world. It was incredible. I totally understand why people travel around the world just to go and see Capri. And we could see early on it was really traffic. It's like a motorway. People really love to come here and take the selfie, which I hope you're going to take after for me. I think I must be the only one with a racing bike on the island. The climbs are pretty steep. I went up and down. I think we did around 20, 25 kilometers around the island just to try the bike.
Want to smell it?
One of my passions is perfumes. I absolutely love perfumes. I was told before coming to Capri that there was this famous perfume place. They only sell and produce from Capri. Please, crew, can I go and have a look and try some perfumes?
Do you have one with like wood, strong?
Yes. See? Yeah.
Ah, brilliant. Yeah, this I really like.
Yes.
Yeah.
Grazie.
Grazie. Now I'm a happy tourist. We can go back.
So there's only one thing that I need to do that I haven't done. I have to commit and I have to go for a dip. It's not so warm. It looks warmer than it is.
How is it?
It's like an ice bath. Fresh.